Hello. Hi. My name is Leslie Knope, and I work for the Parks and Recreation Department. Can I ask you a few questions? Would you say that you are enjoying yourself and having fun, having a moderate amount of fun and somewhat enjoying yourself, or having no fun and no enjoyment? I'm gonna put a lot of fun.
I chose to work in the Arboretum that began as a volunteer because by training and for many years I was a science teacher and was amazed that the students didn't know more about plant life than they did and felt even then, which was probably 30 years ago, that children were not outside as much as I had been when I was a child. And I think there's a great deal to be said for a connection with nature that makes you respect it and want to maintain it, care for it in the future.
Hi, just going to ask you a couple questions about leaves and like the trees they belong to. So if you could identify what tree this belongs to.
I don't know.
Okay. Secondly, we have this one right here. Do you know what tree this belongs to?
No.
Okay. And finally, this one here. All right, well, thank you very much. So I'm just doing this study here at UK to see, like, you know, people that go to UK, if they recognize the trees and the leaves, you know, that are around them as they walk to class or whatever. So if you could you identify this leaf for me?
That looks like a maple leaf.
Yep, that's correct. And then what do you know about this one right here? Do you know what tree that belongs to?
Oak tree.
That's correct as well. And finally, this one right here.
I would say that is a... I don't even know any other trees.
Hey, it's actually an ash tree.
Oh, okay.
So thank you though. Thank you very much. All right. If you could, like, I'm just conducting a survey here to see if people that go to UK recognize like the leaves and trees that are around them as they walk to class. So if you could, please tell me what tree this leaf belongs to. Here's the leaf. All right. Do you know what tree this belongs to?
Is it a sycamore?
That's no. It's actually an ash tree. Okay, next one is, what about this one right here? Do you know what this is?
Oak.
Yeah, you're actually right. It's an oak tree. And then finally, we have this one right here. Do you know what tree this belongs to?
Maple.
There you go.
The United States has 84 million acres dedicated to parks and natural preservation. Size-wise, this is the size of Germany. The Lexington Arboretum itself has over 100 acres. This land offers the opportunity for not only beauty, but enjoyment and education. The Arboretum offers land for picnics and sunbathing. There is room to throw a football or go for a walk. If you are looking to go for a walk, the Walk Across Kentucky offers a trail where the seven regions of Kentucky are displayed. Not only are you exercising, but you are also learning about the regions from the natural species that are labeled in each specific region. Children visiting the park are guaranteed a great experience. The Children's Garden offers multiple interactive learning opportunities. They can learn to grow their own plants in the garden. Also, they learn to appreciate and value the earth. This positive influence and interest caused by the youngest members of society help to inspire the next generation to give back to the community through the Arboretum and parks later in life. The children having the fun experience now, exploring the wonders of nature, are the future volunteers and conservationists of the world.
One of the main features that has been growing since the beginning and will continue to grow is the Walk Across Kentucky, which is the path, the blacktop path, that goes around the perimeter, and that's 2 miles. So a lot of people come to walk and enjoy that. But as you go along it, you're going through the seven geophysical regions of the state, and the plants in each region were collected in that region of the state. So you've actually got, you know, a conservation issue going. And the trees have gotten large enough now that as you walk through, you can see how the different regions have different trees. And there's actually signage that will talk about the rocks and what makes the soils, the subsoils of the bentonite soils that are good for that particular plant.
Volunteering is what keeps the Arboretum running. If it were not for the help of the 280 volunteers that continue to return to the Arboretum, then there would be a downfall in its upkeep. There are a variety of ways to get involved with the Arboretum. There's something for everyone. There's service in everything from helping at the Welcome Center to planning special events, to helping get grants, and even playing with children in the children's garden. In addition to this, the second Saturday of every month is a work day open to anyone willing to help. If you are looking for a more serious commitment, one can even adopt a garden.
I would like to see the park system expanded and supported, and perhaps even have little public parks or connector parks, and I think we're beginning to see a little of that now. Things, each entity perhaps having its own unique place in the system, so whatever you hope to enjoy that day, soccer and go to Masterson Station as you do now, or the opportunity to be in a lot of different places for a lot of different reasons, enjoying the outdoors.
The Arboretum is a great way to spend time with family and friends while getting fresh air and enjoying a beautiful scenery. The option of having an arboretum in close proximity and even parks is taken for granted. Lexington itself has over 100 parks in its vicinity. Not all communities are so fortunate. We all have the opportunity to be involved with something greater than ourselves by giving back to these parks and arboretums. The first step, though, is through education about the natural world. The second is taking time to give back to nature. Several dreams, every
obstacle imagined. Now it's over a mile away from me, so I'm kind of deterred from going, but if it was closer, I would definitely volunteer there more often and just go there to read a book under a tree.
I mean, is there a volunteer effort? Because if I could kind of just join there and, like, I don't know, maybe help plant some trees, that's pretty fun. Like, I've been trying to get into more community service because I feel like I need to do more for my community, because, like, my community's giving me so much. So I've been in Lexington since I was about born, and entire Lexington has always given me so much. Like, I'm getting a full ride to UK because, I don't know, like, my community's done so much for me. So I feel like I need to do something back for my community. So, yeah, definitely. Beautiful to watch reach for the sky, then explode, but I still can't believe it happened, though. Is the end, not the end again.
Yeah.